What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 9 of the Ultimate Let's Play Bassmasters Classic. And today we're going to finish the tournament at Lake Ronkonkoma. First thing I want to do, though, is pick up a new spoon bait to make up for the one I lost last time. And actually, that's all I'm going to be able to do here. So I'm going to go ahead and pick that up, get out of here, and get on the lake. I've already got a pretty commanding lead in this tournament. And again, really, I'm just trying to outdo my performance at the last two lakes here. So I want to say my goal is like, 107, 108 or something like that. Well, I'm going to shoot for 110. Maybe I'll get lucky. Maybe catch a couple of 8-pounders today. Go ahead and start right here. Alright, let's see what we can get here on our first cast of the day. Fortunately, it's a pike and I want that one. Oop. Looks like we have our first customer of the day here. Want to see if I can get to come down a little bit here. Let it drag along the floor so I don't have to worry about my height here. There we go. Okay, got it to grab. It's going to be a small one to start off. Hopefully not too small. Starting to breach. Gonna give me a little bit of a breathing room there. Really, I don't mind catching the small ones early on in the day because I know basically they're gonna act as placeholders in the event I do not catch any of the big ones. I'll at least have something to show for my efforts today. And our first catch of the day is in the boat. And it is a 3-pound, 1-ounce. Not a bad start of the day. Charlie Chum and William Emerson currently have crossed the 50-pound mark. Wonder how the second and third place races are going to finish up. I think it's safe to say that I'm going to win the tournament with what I have. I do want to give myself a bit of a cushion, though, just in case. I don't know exactly what the, minimum requirements are for each of these lakes, but they seem to be going up every lake I participate in. And honestly, I believe for the last one, I'm definitely going to have to go all out. Because I believe in the final lake of the game, you have to win to beat the game. You can't finish top 5 or top 3 like you have in this tournament and some previous tournaments. You gotta win the whole thing. Now I got 3 fish coming at me here. The one I think is out of range now. Oh, missed it there. And honestly, you should just make an effort to not just place, but try to win the tournaments as well, because you will earn prizes. You will earn a lot more money, even though I seem to have more than I can spend right now. Really, the only thing I'm really missing right now is, like a new motor for the boats, which will just allow me to travel a little bit quicker. I've already got the best fish finder. I've got all the reels. I've got all the rods. Hell, I've got all the lures, too. So, I'm in pretty good shape, and I still got a grand in my pocket. Now we're going to add another 2-pounder to the live well. Better than nothing, I guess. Oh, looks like we have had a change in second and third. Corey Crispin and now Zoe Shelby. So it may be a little back and forth between those positions here. Yeah, I got to finish the top 3 in order to move on to the next lake. This is my last day to add to my live well here. Add to my total. So now I'm in this little shallow corner of the lake. I'm gonna try fishing around here a little bit. I will say the spoonbait, though best suited for deeper water, is actually working out pretty well in these more shallow areas. Honestly, it's just been tried and true. And this one has been my ace in the hole. I did try and mix it up, but in the end, this has been my key to victory so far. I already landed my third fish of the day. Hooked it at least. Won't land it until I get it into the boat. This guy's fighting me a little bit here. He's not really coming close to breaking my line here, despite me reeling and pulling with all my strength here. And this guy's barely fighting now. Looks like he's run out of steam, so he's just being dragged along now. We'll add another 2 pounds, 1 ounce to the live well. We're down 7-2 in the day. Another change in the standings. Clyde Casey's now taking second spot. Really, at this point, I'm just curious who's going to take the second and third spots and the trophies, because I already know that I'm pretty confident that I'm going to take the gold here. Now we're going to go into some deeper water here. This is where I think I thrive with the equipment that I use, and honestly, as you probably guessed by now, it's a personal preference. This is a deeper part of the lake, surrounded by some shallow areas. It's also a little bit cooler around here, so I think the colder it gets, the better chances I'll have finding fish deeper in the depths. I don't want that pike, although it doesn't look like there's anybody around here. Trying to pull back a few feet at a time. Ooh, almost went a little too fast there. But I do want to grab this big guy here. This is probably going to be at least 7 or 8 pounds here. This one, if it's big enough, is probably going to stay in the live well. If we can get it to breach a few times, wear it down a bit, this will be a nice addition to the live well. Alright, we landed it. Let's go ahead and get a measurement. 7 pounds, 6 ounces. A beautiful catch. 14.8 on the day, and I've actually now at 87.2 on the day now. I shouldn't say the day, it's the tournament. So I'm nearing the century mark yet again here in this final day of the tournament. Trying to find a good spot where there's a lot of beeps and there's some depth here. Honestly, I think I just did a full-on U-turn here. I think I'm in relatively the same spot as I was. Only now I'm facing the other direction. We might have a potential big one here? No, it's going to be a small one. Hey, if it's at least 2 pounds, it'll make the live well, so might as well reel it in. It's nice having a full live well. That means you are definitely getting the catches. And you've got a bare minimum that you're going to be going in with. Depending that you don't slack off and dock late and get late to the weigh-in. Which I've come nowhere near close to doing, thankfully. If you've forgotten, you are penalized 2 ounces for every minute that you're late. And if you're more than 20 minutes late, you're DQ'd for the whole day. And if you're falling behind, that will just make all your efforts all for naught. That's a very bad feeling. Unfortunately, this fast does not meet the minimum requirements, so I'm going to have to throw it back. Now, Clyde Casey, Will Yamerson now takes second and third positions, respectively. They're over around 67 pounds each. I think I'm in a more shallow area here. I did definitely hear some beeps around here. See one way out in the distance there, but it's too far out of range. I'm going to have to let that one go. Maybe if I get in a better position, I can probably make an effort to go for that one again. I don't want that pike either. Here we go. This is one I want. You're pretty close to the boat as well. You're only 35 feet away. Let's get down to my level. You know, you looked a lot bigger from the distance. But now I'm going to question if this guy is even going to make the live well. Let's see what we got here. 2-2. All right. Not the best in the world, but it does make the live well, at least for now. I find myself about a dozen ounces shy of 90 right now. Let's try going to the corner again. It's a nice deep spot around here. We're in the southeasternmost point of the lake here, farthest away from the docks. Quiet little spot to fish alone here. In the deeper area. Let's see what we can grab, if anything. Want to get a nice big one. Ask and thou shalt receive. Come here. Okay, let's bring this bad boy in. I don't want to push it, because he was starting to pull on my line a bit there. Thought I heard a couple pops there. If I pull too hard, I'll break the line. And lose another spoon bait. But he's breaching, so it's allowing me time to recover my strength and wearing him out in the process. Alright. Let's weigh this guy in. 7-7, a new high for the day. Now at 22 pounds, 1 ounce for the day. How close am I to 100? I'm at 94.11. Okay. Got about 6 pounds to go. I've got a 27-pound lead over second place. Let's keep fishing here. That wind kind of carried my lure away. Not quite where I wanted it to be. Well, might as well have a look. I'm already got the line in the water here. I'm Who's this here? Is this a, oh, never mind. I'll take you instead. You look like a big one. Nope, don't turn away. Come on. Come back here. Yeah, I don't want the smaller one. I want the big one. Alright, it's right there. Take it. Thank you. Put it right in front of you. You got down to my level. It all fell into place, but I gotta reel this guy in 90 feet. So a real risk of him breaking my line if I'm not careful. But anytime I can get him to breach, then that's a good thing. Alright, that took a lot out of me, but I got him in the boat. 5 pounds, 6 ounces, okay. One of the smaller big ones that I've gotten. Did have to throw one of the 2-pounders back. I'm at an even 98 pounds. Still got about 5 hours left in the tournament. Let's see if I can add to this total here. Getting a lot of the big ones down here, so I think I should probably just stick around this place. Stay in the deeper parts of the water. Ooh. Almost got intercepted by that trout there. But I see a bass. And I want this one. Okay. Guy in. I know this guy will make the live well. And we got him. A fine catch indeed. 7 pounds, 5 ounces. I think that's going to put me over the century mark here. Yep, 103.3. We actually have a tie for a second right now between Casey and Emerson. Alright, I think I've milked that for all it's worth, so let's move on to another part of the lake. Be sure there are plenty more big ones biting. Let's try this corner. It's a bit more shallow, but you never know. Much action around here. Do see something in the distance. That's a pike. I don't want that. Any bass around here? No? Just another trout. Eh. No luck here. Fish I was looking for up there. Let's start a combing the bottom of the middle of the lake here at the deepest part. Going about 40-odd feet deep here. And right away, big one coming and calling here. Comes right to me. Trying not to reel too fast. That's why he was kind of pulling me a bit there. You have two reel buttons. And if you hit them both together, you can reel incredibly fast, but you do run the risk of it pulling the line too tight and snapping it. But sometimes you do have to use both buttons. Or else the fish is just gonna yank your line and you're not gonna be able to reel them in. New high for the day, 7 pounds, 13 ounces. Puts me at 35.5. I'm now at 107.15. I think I might have topped my score from Eagle Lake, I believe. It's not even halfway through the day right now. I wonder if I'm going to be able to top this. So we got another bass here. It's another small one, though. I think I've gotten to the point, though, where these smaller ones are really not going to help me at all. I think my smallest catch right now in the live well is a 5-pounder, so this one's probably only going to come in at around maybe 2 or so. If we're lucky, 3. Nevertheless, it's probably not going to be enough. You know, if I was designing this game, I'd probably make time go a little bit quicker just to make it a little bit more challenging. Because I've been pretty much maxing out my live wells barely halfway through the day. And starting to become a non-challenge at this point. Really, the only challenge is, can I outdo my previous tournaments? Because I think I've found the secret to always doing well. And that's the spoon bait. I will say this is definitely not my favorite fishing game of the in the world. I still think Hook's Real Motion Fishing is a pretty good blast as well. That and Trophy Bass 2 on the PC back in the old days, back when I was a teenager. Used to play that game a lot. And that's a trout. I don't want that. Oh, here's a big one. Hopefully it's at least 5.5 pounds. All right, let's bring this guy in. If it's big enough, we'll make the live well. If not, lunch. Nah, these just catch and release, unfortunately. And plus, I've never really liked fish. I will eat pretty much anything nowadays, but any kind of seafood just does not agree with me. That's probably why I never go to Red Lobster. Usually when I take my mom out every so often. And this missed the live well for about 1 ounce. One single ounce kept it from getting us the live well. And while it would make a couple decent meals, 5 pounds of fish, well, again, I'm not going to eat it. And, yeah. She kind of stuck on the sticks here. But yeah, I do take my mom out to dinner every so often. I do have a very good relationship with her. She likes Red Lobster, but I've never really been a big fan. It's pretty much the extent of what we do together nowadays. It's just every so often just go out for a meal or something. Another potential big catch here. Hopefully this one will make the live well. A little disappointing throwing that 5-pounder back. We're actually closing in on high noon here. Starting to run a little low on time here, though there is a chance I may just call it a day early. Was this that same fish? Another 5-pound, 5-ouncer having to throw it back. I swear, this is starting to turn into the my first fishing derby. I'm in kind of a high-risk area here. Here in the sticks here, but we'll see if searching this little area pays off. Hopefully it's not that same 5-pound fish again. He's starting to circle around, so hopefully he can see my spoon bait from this distance. No, trout, you get away from me. It's not the same fish, I can safely say that. Unfortunately, this looks like a smaller fish. This is likely going to be thrown back. I'm sorry to say. 2 pounds, 15 ounces. Yeah, so this is probably not the best spot to look here. I'm going to back up just a little bit so I'm away from the sticks. Just gotta be careful if you get your boat lodged in there. It may be difficult to pry yourself loose. Kind of coming up empty here. This whole part of the lake looks deserted. Honestly, it looks like an undersea desert. All the rocks, sand, the reefs that look like cactus. And this lone fish coming to me. Which unfortunately is probably going to be thrown back. Because this looks like a smaller one. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't even made the live well even if it was empty. So 5-6 is still my low on the day, which is actually saying quite a bit. That means my catches have been pretty solid up to this point. The ones that have made the live well, at least. I'm going to start making my way closer to the docks. Just so we get ready to get ready for the weigh-in when it's time. I would like to have at least one more big catch before the day is over. I think I'm a little too close to the boat now, so I may have to throw another line out. Try and throw this one out a little bit further, though I think the wind may have carried it. There we go. This looks like a big one. This may be an 8-pounder. I want to get this guy in the live well. Just hitting the 1 o'clock hour now. We're starting to run a little low on time here. This guy's breaching. That's a good sign. Just gotta be careful though. Don't let him break the line here. All right, come to the live well. Look at that, 8-6. One of my bigger catches of the day. I'm probably not going to top that. I now have 110 pounds, 15 ounces, so I have definitely beat my Eagle Lake score. So I'm going to start heading back to the docks here. A little bit closer. Maybe get one more line out. Maybe another 8-pounder will come my way. Are you going to come my way? You're not worth it. You're too small. Once I got a better look at him, it was just not worth it. Empty there. Now we're back where we started, right next to the dock. Maybe I can land one more big one. And honestly, at this point, I may just go ahead and go to the weigh-in early, because I've already got a pretty insurmountable lead. And this would be a good way to end the episode with this nice big one here. Reel it in from 100 feet out. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come to me. Get in my live well. Not worried about time, I got plenty of it. It looks like we're gonna make the catch here. We got him. Mm-hmm. 8 pounds, 7 ounces. That is my top catch of the day. That will put me at 112 pounds, 1 ounce for the tournament. You know what? I think I've done enough damage. And rather than waste everybody else's time with fish that are probably not going to make the live well, I'm just going to go ahead and weigh in and end the tournament. So let's see who officially comes in second and third. It's going to be Chum in second and Crispin in third. 8 ounces separating the two. And we have won the Lake Ronkonkoma tournament. Let's go ahead and get our trophy and our cash and prizes. I don't think we broke the lake record, unfortunately. But we do win $3,000, and we also won a new motor for the boat. Okay. That's a decent prize there. But anyway, I'm going to call it quits here. Next time, we're going to start the tournament here at Sydney Lake. And I hear rumors that there is a big monster fish hiding somewhere around here. And we're going to try and catch it. But until then, I'm going to call it quits for now. This is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.